So, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another video. As you know, this channel is mainly Star Wars. As you can see, I've got some brand new Star Wars stuff here. And I decided to do this yearly thing where about this time of year I would write all the Star Wars films. Grab right here. That's how I did it, was early 2020. And the list is a lot different from then. Obviously, on this list, we are featuring Rogue One and Solo. So before we start, please make sure to click subscribe. We're on the road to 100 subs. We're currently on 80 at the moment, which I'm fucking gassed at. Thank you all for subscribing. Greatly appreciate it. And yeah, so let's get started with the number 11 spot, which I've got The Last Jedi. Poor film, not much direction, kind of lazy story writing. Kylo Ren was really nice, the cinematography was great, great, good planet, love it, but if I'm going to be honest, I haven't watched it since it came out, so I can't really remember much about it, but it's just so poor. The potential as well that JJ left with episode 7 should have been replicated in episode 8, the mass potential of it. But it was poorly downgraded to a film about Star Wars that we don't want. Yeah, I'm never watching that film again, honestly. But number 11, The Last Jedi. Coming in at number 10, probably the biggest change in this list is The Phantom Menace. It's just gone really downhill from last time I saw. It's just, my knowledge of films got better and more broad and more, just better in general. This is just a poor film, honestly. Darth Maul is probably the only cool thing in it. Obviously, it's just Anakin, but it's not a memorable film. It's not a likeable film for me. Obviously, it's very mixed on what it, if it's good or not, and I'm in the section that says it's no longer good. I think it's always something with Star Wars that the visual effects and the cinematography is top class, but in this case it's probably one of the worst cinematography, probably the worst one for cinematography. It's not too advanced with it, it's not anything too bougie, but it does show the vast world of Star Wars in a great detail, and that's probably why I like this film, probably the only reason. Do I hate it as much as Last Jedi? No, I don't hate it. I don't hate any of the Star Wars films, I just greatly dislike Last Jedi, and then the rest I'm not too fussed about. I'm just disappointed by that one, just ruined. But yeah, number 10 for me is The Phantom Menace. Coming in at number 9, we have got The Rise of Skywalker. This a big change as well from the last time I did this list, if I'm being honest. Definitely gone downhill since I first watched it, a bit like Phantom Menace. The film, very plain, very boring, nothing too exciting going on. Raids Palpatine, but she becomes Skywalker at the end of it. Kylo dies, which is not the best idea. Poe is a Spice Runner. Finn is a Force Sensitive. That should be Finn. That should be Rey. We're introduced to Zoe Bliss. Lando returns. Janna. Epic fights. Palpatine versus Rey, we hear the voice of Jedi past, even though there's rumours that they should have actually been there. This film is just very annoying. It's like a first draft of the film for me. It doesn't feel like the final project or the final product. It's like the idea that you have at a pitch for a meeting for the film, not the actual film. And that's why it's so far down my list now. The reason that it was so high before is because of the hype of the film. So, yeah. The Rise of Skywalker comes in at number 9 and is a big disappointment. Coming in at number 8, we've got Solo, Star Wars Story. Solid film, solid acting from Alden. I can't say his last name, it's something like Alden Ehrenreich, something like that. But Han Solo's film, solid. The way that he got his last name, disappointing. Chewie this film, as in every film, you can't really mess up Chewie nowadays. Rock solid, top tier. The storyline in this, Dryden Voss, who's played by Paul Bettany, strong villain. Darth Maul at the end, very intriguing. Obviously there's rumours of Solo 2 as a Disney Plus series, where it's more, it's a story. I'd like to see that, explain more of what Solo's doing before episode 4. I feel like the ending of Solo's a bit rushed. I feel like they knew there would be a second one, so they had to give him the Falcon in that film. But I would have liked for them to have saved that for part 2 as one of these side storylines, or like the side quests. But what can you do? Solo, number 8. Strong film. It's definitely overseen due to the Last Jedi backlash. So if you haven't seen this film called Last Jedi, I would recommend you watch it. So number 8, Solo, A Star Wars Story. Coming in at number 7, we've got Attack of Clones. Now, this is the highest jump up my list, because besides with dialogue, the special effects is really solid. We finally get to see Yoda fight, you see right here. We see Anakin go to rage, which is probably one of the best scenes in Star Wars. Just dual effects in the background is... we get to see the bond between Anakin and Obi-Wan. We finally get to see Hayden Christensen as Anakin Skywalker. All the foundation, the true foundation for episode 3. Episode 1 kind of feels like a misjointed piece to the puzzle. Even though it's considered the better one of the two, I don't agree so. But that's just my opinion. Obviously, you can leave yours down in the comments below. Where I respond to everyone who isn't mean to me. Anyways, we get to finally see Count Dooku in this film after the destruction of Darth Maul to the hands of Jedi Padawan Obi-Wan Kenobi. We figure out a certain man called Darth Sidious, who we know is to be Chancellor Palpatine, is in control of the Senate, but Dooku only says Darth Sidious. And obviously we don't know who Darth, well, the Jedi don't know who Darth Sidious is. But if you pay attention to the original trilogy, you know who Darth Sidious is. And if you look at the clues of the film, you'll know that Darth Sidious is indeed Chancellor Palpatine. But the reason this film jumped up so high is because I've come to enjoy it a bit more. I've come to appreciate it. Yoda looking... very scary, very scaly, old. Looks like he's taken my electricity bill. But besides from that, number 7 is Attack of the Clones. Coming in at number 6, we have got the best film in the sequel trilogy. By far, The Force Awakens. Very great start to the film. Obviously we see similarities to this and episode 4, which I don't mind. It's a new story still. Obviously there's lots of similarities between films nowadays, which I don't think's really a fuss. Finn, an ex-stormtrooper who should have turned into an actual Jedi, but instead is this little wombat over here. BB-8 is kind of like the R2-D2 of this story, or C-3PO. He's kind of a mumbo-jumbo of both. We get to see probably the saddest death in Star Wars. That is the death of Han Solo. We are introduced to the best villain that we've seen in a long time, Kylo Ren, and his evil master Snoke. We don't know much about Snoke in this film, but you see the later trilogy. Well, later in the trilogy, he's just a clone. Makes me want to bash my head against the floor. Episode 7 has such great promise, but episode 8 and 9 just put its dick on the table and said, my will. but number 6, Force Awakens, it's ruined by the later films, in my opinion. Coming in at number 5, we've got Rogue One. It was difficult placing this film for me. It's a bit of a topsy-turvy one. Some bits I don't like, some bits I do like. It's kind of meshed together. It's probably the hardest film to place on this list, besides from Return of the Jedi, but I don't really know. It's a solid film, but I feel like without Darth Vader, it'd probably be below Solo. Vader makes this film so great. The hallway scene, big meme nowadays, obviously, as we know. Obviously, K2SO is a really good character. I'm sad and disappointed that she's not going to be in Andor. Obviously, we know that TV show's coming out. I'm not doing a review on it, honestly. I couldn't give a rat's ass about that series, man, honestly. But this is a good watch. The second best Disney Star Wars film, I'll say that. But now that we've entered the top 5, Rogue One is your number 5. Number 4 is a film to kick it all off, A New Hope. This film, we've seen that it hasn't really aged well nowadays, but it's still a solid film. Some of the stuff hasn't aged well, like the Darth Vader Ben Kenobi fight. If you've seen C-38 Reimagined, you'll see what I mean. But it introduced us to so many characters that we have an emotional connection to nowadays. We got Luke, Leia, Han, and Chewie. Right, yeah. All these we have an emotional connection to Star Wars fans, as well as original trilogy fans. Let's see right here. Chewie and Luke having a fight. Also, we have a connection to all these characters for a reason, and that's because they are so iconic and so great and so relatable. And that's something I feel like modern films are struggling to do with, besides from the MCU. The MCU is just a great relatability platform. But just modern films, like films from Paramount, Universal, Sony, except for Spider-Man, they're just finding it hard to relate to. They're just going so out of the depth that it's not becoming relatable anymore, whilst films like this are. I looked at some statistics earlier and I found out the money that it made in 1977, if you translated it to today's money, it's $3.3 billion. So if this film came out today and made the exact same money as it did in 1977, it would have actually been $3.3 billion today. And that would have been more than the reparations of World War One, when they were halved. So even nowadays, this would have still been the highest grossing film of all time if it was made today, well, 2 years ago, 2019, and it made the same amount of money, but in the 1977 terms, which translates to 2010s, you know what I mean? But this film is great. We're introduced to the most iconic villain of all time, the best villain of all time, Darth Vader. Obviously, there's an argument between who the real best villain is, Vader or Palpatine. Another video for another time. But this film, solid film, always be remembered as the best Kickstarter to the most iconic franchise that will ever exist on the planet. Besides from Marvel, that'll be a bit of a controversial one though. I've done a video about that, so it'll be up in the comment in the top corners. Marvel vs. Star Wars. Yeah. Before we get into our top three though, I'm going to talk to you guys a little bit about what's going on. Obviously, start of March, I'm going to start rolling out some sick content. This is just the beginning of it. I'm revisiting a lot of Star Wars shit. The springtime for me is mainly when I start to become a Star Wars fan again. I don't know why it should be the winter times when the films actually come out, but I digress. I'm planning on making some sick Star Wars content, going back to the old games, old films, maybe doing some watch parties for these films, doing some fantasy fights like Anakin vs. Grievous, Mace Windu vs. Dooku, Yoda vs. Starkiller, Luke vs. Obi-Wan versus Rey versus Anakin and all that malarkey. I wanted to do some stuff about the films as well, which is why I'm doing this very complicated list. The top three were very hard to place. You'll see what I mean, but yeah. We're trying to lock down a new date for the chase. I've been able to talk to Chris from LDG for a little bit because I've been busy. But trust me, they will probably be working on it whilst I'm not there at the moment. But their links will be down in the description below for their great support towards the channel. So their Twitter and YouTube links will be below. But is that it? No. Subscribe to my channel, 100 subs, try to get that by end of the year. I'm already smashing the target that I need to be at the moment. I should be at 74, but I'm currently at 80. So we're currently smashing the target at the moment. So if we want to speed this process along, then maybe there might be a giveaway at 100 subs, maybe not, I'm not too sure yet. But let's get into the top three. Coming in at number three is, in my opinion, the most underrated Star Wars film, and that is Return of the Jedi. This film has the best end battle, in my opinion, Luke versus Vader, and then also Lando blowing up the Death Star, Han and Leia and Chewie, 3PO, on Endor with the Ewoks. The Ewoks I don't really mind, I don't really care. It just shows that no matter what language or how you speak or how you dress or what you wear and shit, doesn't matter as long as you're fighting for the correct cause and the same cause. So, yeah. Definitely an emotional one, this is. Han finally released from his kryptonite after 3 years. Obviously the Star Wars fans were left wondering from 1980 to 1983 if Han actually survived. Thankfully he did. So obviously there was talks about Harrison Ford actually wanting to kill Han off in episode 6, which he confirmed. Carrie Fisher, Leia, brilliant job. Peter Mayhew as Chewie, always iconic. The fighting in this film was really strong. Mark Hamill as Luke in this film was absolutely amazing. Obviously, for the technology back in the 80s, there weren't really much they could do with Luke's high acrobatic skills. But as you saw in The Mandalorian, season 2 episode 8, oh, Luke can do more than just swinging a lightsaber, let me tell you that. But yeah, a very strong film. Definitely the most underrated Star Wars film in my opinion. I don't really see people giving this high enough praise. And honestly, when I was younger, like, when I didn't know nothing about films, I just watched them for the enjoyment. This was better than everything else in the franchise. This is my favourite film. But now it's not number three. It's obviously had a jump up from, I think it was like number six or seven the last time. But Return of the Jedi is number three. Obviously the top two are kind of obvious, but which one is in which position? Let's find out. Oh, my head hurts after this discussion. Number two, I don't know if I'm going to regret this, but I'm going with Empire Strikes Back. Very emotional film. It's very traumatic. I won't say traumatic, but you know what I mean. It's very memorable for the stuff that it does. Definitely taught me a very big lesson when I was younger, that no matter how hard you train, no matter how hard you work, there will always be someone who does it harder and better and is better than you, and you also have to prepare for it. And also it shows the good guys don't always win, for me. Obviously, we have a modern day version of that, which is Infinity War. But I feel like this one is the most iconic one, especially with the spoiler alert. The end scene where Vader announces to Luke that he is his daddy. Luke has daddy Vader. Oh, he's sad. Obviously, the Emperor is finally revealed by a hologram. We see his face for the first time. Obviously, it was someone else. Can't remember a name. I know it was a she. Or I think it was a monkey or something. But it was revealed as Ian McDiarmid as Palpatine, which is some top class casting. Very sick film. We are introduced to Yoda for the first time, who is played by the almighty wonderful Frank Oz. Yeah, I had to put it second. In the first place, it's just too good to pass upon. But yeah, I had to put this in second place. I'm sorry to all you original fans out there. Chris, I know you're going to be disappointed in this one, because I know this is your favourite film of all time, but I had to put it here. So let's go and look at our number one spot, whilst being who is to the future. Forget, I have no idea what's going on with me today, but coming in at number one, we have Revenge of the Sith. My most watched Star Wars film by far. This is full for resume, as you see here, because I watched it last night. I've watched pretty much every week this year. Very good film. Fucking love it. Hayden Christensen as Darth Vader, the legful Darth Vader. Imagine you just go up to Darth Vader and order a legless chicken. Just pick up Darth Vader and give it to him. But solid acting by everyone in this film. Ewan McGregor, obviously, is probably the best thing to happen to the prequels. Definitely one of the things that weren't hindered by the prequels from the originals is Ewan McGregor's acting as Obi-Wan, or Obi-Wan in general. Palpatine is a very difficult one, because he's a bit of topsy-turvy in this film. He's revealed as Sith Lord, and then he gets Anakin to do some wiggity-wiggity and kill the Separatists. Also, that seems a good thing to some people, but to other people that might seem as a bad idea. But let's be honest, this film is probably the reason why most of you are here. Films like this and Empire Strikes Back, top films, great films, probably the best films in Star Wars history, and they probably will be for a long time. And if I'm being honest, I wouldn't have it any other way. This film is a lifesaver for me. If I'm bored, I could always go to this film and watch this man do his thing like a fucking G. And when I heard he'd come back as Vader, I was fucking gassed. And I'm going to be honest, I'm disappointed that this was all announced whilst I was having my break in November. But we move. This is my number one spot, good old Hayden as Vader in episode 3. But that is it for today. As you see here, this is the official list. But yeah, thank you all for watching. Big month in March. I think we were trying to aim for two chase shows, episode 2 and 3, to come out in March. I don't know. But if you want to see if that actually happens, please make sure to click subscribe. And when you click subscribe, it'll turn grey. And to the right of it, there'll be a big old notification bell. You can have it for occasional or all videos. Put it on all. Please leave a like. It helps me in the algorithm greatly. Kind of pushes me some positive facts to YouTube, so it pushes my videos out more. But guys, I'm going to be honest, that's the end of the video. I could talk about this for years, but as you all know, I'm not good at long distance talking. But I'm glad you're all here today to watch this. And to all my Jedi and Sith friends out there, it's been your boy. This is probably one of my last videos for a day or two. I'll upload Thursday, I think, or Friday. Thursday or Friday, keep an eye out, because I might do a video or a stream. You don't know. As JJ said, it's a lottery. Check out my channel. Take care, everyone. Peace.